Hey guys, what's going on? It's Nock. Welcome along to a brand new video. Today we're going to play Funnelfication by Narkodes, as requested by Libby Bapper. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. But without further ado, let's jump into the description. Please read. You already guessed it. The main elements of this map are the Sendificator and a funnel. It's definitely an advantage to know how the Sendificator works because there's no tutorial room. That being said, here are some important points. Yep. I don't think we need to read that. We know that. No cube tossing. Sendificator is connected to the laser and regular cube button. Interesting. The conductive plate is portable. Laser collision off. F6, F7 is recommended. And then we have some thanks and solutions and videos and bits and pieces. Just like that. All right. Well, without further ado, let's jump in. Libby said in his request that, that they thought I would enjoy this puzzle. So let's see if we can do just that, shall we? Music from Soccer Band, the RPG, I think it's Soccer Band? Yeah. I know Mike has got some... I was querying it because I know Mike has got other music other than just Soccer Band, the RPG, so... But I'm pretty sure this one did feature in the game. Alright, so that's the... So that's the weighted cube that is connected also to the Sendificator button, right? Those panels are set behind a laser field. It's going to move that, so... Where to begin? Oh. Well, okay. I thought that was death. I thought I was dying a horrible death. There we go. Okay. Well, kind of makes sense, I guess. Not often you see a catwalk in a part of... Apologies for that, guys. So, this is where we obviously sendificate from. That's where we're going to funnel grab from. That's the button for the... Look like I could do something there. Interesting. Grating. Very interesting grating positioning. Maybe should stop the cube going too far or something, or stop it from doing something or other. I don't know. Alright, let's go back because I'm not seeing much progress in this direction. Not seeing much progress in any direction at the minute, so. So maybe I need to funnel a cube onto the Sendificator. Possibly. There's definitely no way back up to the top, is there? That panel's not for humans. Okay. thing. I did a thing, and I got a thing. Okay. But by doing said thing... Oh, okay, we've got the conductive plate, haven't we? Totally forgot about that. Okay, so we need to do... So we need to control both things then to... A road to nowhere. So that's exit requirement. Not that I've seen where the exit is at the minute. Okay, so maybe I could do something similar to what I did before. See, the problem is though doing that, I mean, I've got to do it now because I've committed, but the problem is we'll pull the cube back into there. Is that a problem? I don't know. Let's find out. Okay. Didn't necessarily expect that. Sure, it helps though. Hold on, maybe I could have got that to work. Alright, let's just try that again a minute. So, jump through here. Make it onto here. I want to do it properly, please, just to prove that I can do things. Don't want to be, like, assuming I can do things when I can't. Alright. Yeah, that's why I couldn't do that. Now I remember. Now I remember. Okay, so that's what that panel does. It allows me to go back up there. Okay. Seems like a very slow funnel. So getting that on there, it's simply just going to respawn that cube, isn't it? Which anyway, at the minute, I can't do anything about. I can do, but there's nothing up there to really. I was thinking I could pull myself up, but there's not really anything there. I can see or do or use. So that's something I could do. Oh, hold on. So, okay, so let me just go back a sec to where we had this. So what if I went and did something along the lines of, man, that funnel is so slow. Okay. Don't have to worry too much about the regular cube. So, from here, I'm actually going to get the other cube as well. Just for safety. Sorry for safety, but just so we know that we've got it. My baby, she's got it. Alright, let's try a few scenarios here. That scenario is a big fat fail. So, that one's no good to us. Can't hit that from over there, so I was wondering whether or not I could do all this from over in the other position. Guess the answer is no, though. Okay. So, oh, I can do it from there. I was thinking, can I hit it while this is on the centrifugator? I was thinking, no, I can't do that. But I can do that. Okay, so do that. And then we'll head back here. It needs to be positioned a little bit more forward than I was putting it. Okay, so I do this. This. Portal on here. Portal on here. Oh, ready to do the cube. Alright. We need this cube here. And so we can't do what we need to do. So our position is more forward than I did last time, hopefully. Excellent. Bit of a slow start, I'll admit, but we are, I feel like we're rocking it a bit now. Alright, so that goes up to there, that's that. Less than that. Did I send the right cube? Is the next question. And I think the answer to that is yes, because I can't send another cube. Alright, so my mistake there was, here's my mistake, so I would have had a Portland there, and a Portland there, right, and then we centrificate. Now I can go up to here, that was my mistake. Okay, save. Okay, so now I have a reversed funnel. But I still wonder. Yeah, no. It's got to be this cube. The other cube cannot come up here. Just wanted to make sure the cube wouldn't go past there. Okay. So, now that we have this, so I need a cube up here. This next part is going to clearly be about laser in position. And how we go about doing that. I forgot to jump out there. Okay, so that changes things quite dramatically, or quite drastically, even. All right, so what can we do from here? I mean, we could effectively... So we could effectively respawn the cube, but doing that will do, I mean, the funnel will be reversed. And I can't get in there. Let me see if that would help. I could do something along the lines of... this. So I could easily get into there now. Funnelfication this cube does nothing for us because we have to press the button to recall this cube to funnelfication it. So, I'm not sure that's the best move. Could I potentially? I could get the cube up here like this using the funnel. Potentially. So, what can I do with this funnel? Thing is, though, once I'm across here, I can't get back, so without respawning the cube, so I don't think that's a good idea. Unless, do you know what? Maybe it is a good idea. From this setup here, no, it's not, because there's a wall there. I was wondering if I could put the cube over here and aim it over there, but there's the quarter block wall there which is going to stop that from happening. So yeah, I don't think doing that does anything for me, if I'm honest. We're not going to use that for any flinging. It's a quarter block there, so I can't again. It's going to have to be I'm trying to think where I can position this. This area is very suspicious as well to me. That could be why. So return path? Where does that suspicious path go to? I guess there's a way to trap yourself, and that's the way back. For instance, if you were to do something like this. Yeah, okay. Makes perfect sense. Alright, my curiosity is cured. But my headache is not. From here, there's no way to get that laser where I want it, is there? Because again, let's hypothesize here that we've done this and this over to here. We've put that there. If I'd have brought the cube with me, though, like the laser cube I'm talking about. That would put that there. Alright. Let's try that, then. Let's try a different approach here. So, we want to scrap that, because we would have lost that. And we'll have a portal here, a portal there. Take this cube with us. Alright, put that one over this side. Would it work because... work. Because for that to work, I would need to get into the funnel. So I'd already need a cube up there. With the other cube positioned on here. Go through the portal, please. Jeez. Okay. So laser cube down there. Ending will be that. That. No, that won't be the ending. Tell you what might be the ending, though. Going back to that sort of setup that I said was talking about before. So that would mean I would need to get the cube over to here. But that all hinged on getting that cube to the top. And I'm sure this puzzle hinges on doing that very thing. Now, the only way I can see to get that cube up to the top onto that funnel button is using the funnel. The problem is, I'm tired. The problem is, I don't know. I don't know what the problem is. Because... let's just like play this out a minute, hypothetically. So you have that there, okay, it doesn't matter where that cube is, but we would be over here with that on there. We could then stand on here, get this cube back to here, That would then sit there. I could get back across there like that. So yeah, that exit's the exit. I can see both of them things from up the top. So in theory, that works. It does, however, mean we get stuck in the same predicament as before, where I don't know how we get back to the top. And I think that's the pivotal point for me now. I need to work out how to get back to the top when the laser cube is out of play. I know I do it when the laser cube is in play. But not when it's out of play. Can work that out, then I think we're golden. If I left the cube on this side. There isn't a way to permanently open that, is there? Yeah, all right. Well, I'm going to have to go back to the drawing board. I'm out of time at the minute to finish off this map, unfortunately. So, yeah, if I can work out how to get up to the top without using the laser cube, we may solve the rest of the puzzle. So, I'll have a think about it, and we'll be back momentarily. All right, guys, we're back with Funnelfication. And we're actually going to strip things back to an earlier stage. The reason being, based on the assumption that we have portals in the right place, it's actually relatively easy to get the portals where I want them to go. For instance, if I was to have a portal here, and we had this set up here, I realized, hey, I could do that. To put the cube in there. Now, I could probably also manipulate something else a little bit differently. So that I could have the ceiling portal on the portal on the ceiling rather than the floor. If I had it on the ceiling, what I could do is put that through to the floor, portal like this. We could portal something like this. And then we can go like this into the funnel, across to here, and then we could do what I was trying to do yesterday, where we can use the funnel to cube and get the cube up there. So that's what we're going to try and do. But to do that, we need to go back a few steps. We need to go back a few steps. So we're going to take this cube back. So this is going to have to be here. I'm sure we had this set up before. Even if we didn't, I could easily respawn the cube by jumping through there, standing on the button, catching the cube, and coming back over here. Okay, so we need to take this over to here. So our aim of this whole process will be... Our aim of the whole process will be to try and keep a portal on the ceiling at all times. So I think to do that, first off, we're going to have to send... We have to send the cube first. And to send the cube, we're going to have to do this. Actually, scrap that. Once we're up here, we can reset the floor portal, can't we? So that's already in position. Actually, no, we can't do that because of that. Alright, but okay, anyway, I digress. Let's, so let's send the cube. So I think we're going to have to climb over the barrier to send the cube because we need to be able to catch this cube so we can use this cube again. Let's think. Let's see what happens. Shut the wrong pole. Serves me right. So I can actually respawn the other cube now, right? Okay, that's gone through there. Issue now being, though, oh crap, how do I keep a portal at the top? It's alright working out like the next steps, but when you can't find the actual, you can't work out the step needed to get to that point, it's always frustrating. I don't think that's right. It's frustrating because I can't. Because that's angled, that causes the problem. What the hell happened to that cube? Can I do anything different here now? There's no way to get over there, though. That's not what I wanted to try, actually. Yeah, that doesn't work. So this cube is out of play. We've been around, and we've just set that up onto the top. Cinderfate that, I gotta respawn the cube. Gotta respawn the regular cube to cinderfate the laser cube. Oh, hold on a minute. Can I catch the cube? I can catch the cube. Well, in that case, everything just got a little bit easier. Everything got a whole lot easier. Alright, so now we can do this. So if you remember back to countless minutes earlier, the original goal for doing this was so that we could swap the laser cube with the standard weighted cube. That's plopped out there. Alright, we got there. Part 4 of the recording. We finally got there. Okay. So now, I don't believe this cube has to leave this spot anymore. So, can't see any portable surfaces that would be useful from up here. Okay, so we can go across here. Just want to check something real quick. Okay, I spy a new problem. And that new problem B... Actually, maybe not. Actually, maybe yes. Actually, maybe no. I'm indecisive. If you hadn't guessed. Okay. All right, so I remember now. I can't do that and exit because I need to use the laser cube because of the portal surfaces I can see on exit. I have to put the laser cube like over here. That would work. But I think I need to go back to this. So that's the thing we have. We can do this like we've just like reset this. So what I need to do now is get my cube over here. Cube needs to be on here, but then I need a way back. So how do we achieve that? I'd assume that, it's never good to assume, mind you, but I would assume that we need to do it with one cube. Just trying to think if I was up here. If I was up here with the funnel. I don't really see how respawning the cube would benefit me in any way. So I don't think that's the solution. That's what we need to do. I just don't know where to go next. So I'd say here, logical move would be to do something like this and this. Hold on a moment. Let's go back a step. Maybe I need to use the reverse funnel. So we can maybe do something like this. Just place that. Actually, it doesn't matter because I will beat it. So, I did that a little bit prematurely. Alright, so what was I going to do from here, though? So I'm not getting over there. That's for sure. That's too high, even if I had left that there. What was I trying to think of there? Good question. And I can pull myself through now, but I'm going to lose the cube, aren't I? So doesn't really strike me as an intelligent thing to do. Maybe that is the key, though, keeping a portal in that other side. Because it's so difficult to get a portal back in there. Dropping the cube doesn't really do any damage. Drop it through, but then I gotta use the funnel to get it back. If I'm in the funnel, I can't see that conductive plate, so I can't hit that. If only it was possible to recall that cube. See, I'm struggling to think that I'm going to need to re-centrificate the cube. But, I mean, I could be completely wrong. It's a bit of a cheeky path through to there, isn't it? There's an easy kind of, we can easily get it back to there. But present moment, I am completely stuck on this. Like I said, unless... Think about pushing the cube across there, but obviously once I take that off there, the fizzler turns on, so I can't push it through there. Unless I stood up here, that would make sense as to why this would be glass, so I could see when it's in the right position. So what I'm thinking is, take this down, even though I've worked so hard to get this up here, push the other cube hinge that me and get it back up here. Sorry. Because the other thing is, I take that off there and the fizzler turns on. But yeah, I'm wondering if I get both cubes back down here with a portal up there. We'll be able to get back across there though. I can effectively push that across to there where I need it to be. Like there. It doesn't matter if it goes all the way across there though, because with a reverse funnel, gets that in position.
The worst I see in position, sorry.
But once that's in position, I don't see then a way to get the other cube back to the top, which is what we've worked so freaking hard for in the first instance. Alright, well, I've got a couple of different directions that I potentially could take here. I'm going to explore these avenues a bit more, see if I can come up with anything, and hopefully we'll be back. I don't think we're a million miles away now from solving this, but it's just whether or not that cube stays up there, or if it comes back down here, because we cannot see it. We can't see it from here. So once we use it here, we're toast, effectively. So I'll play around. I'll see what we can come up with, and I'll be back momentarily. Hopefully, where we can put this one to bed. Alright guys, we are back with Funnelfication, whatever it's called, I don't know. I had to have a look at a video because I had no idea what I was doing at all. And although I didn't watch a lot of the video, it seems that once you're at this point, it's almost like you're playing as if you're in a cage. So everything you do has got to be from in there. So, yeah, I generally don't know. This is, I'm not 100% sure, but we're going to go up to the top there. And we're going to see what we did. So basically, my idea of using the reverse funnel, just put this here, wasn't a million miles off what we need to do. I did also see that that cube gets respawned, and that's where I got up to. So, what they did was, they did something like this. Well, that didn't exactly go as I intended. So let's imagine that this didn't go as intended. So we still have this cube up here at the minute. Okay, so what they then did was cube over here, and this is how they respawned this. Oh, but wait a second. Things aren't going well at the minute. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, so that went across to there like that. Then we needed to catch it in here. I mean, this is... Oh, you know what? We need to do this again. My head is completely wrecked with this. So here's what we'll do. Yeah, this is what I mean, that my head is just completely mushed. This is probably a tougher map. It's not probably a tougher map, it is a tougher map. I mean, there's no... It's hard to get, like, the visual cue there. But basically what we're going to do is catch it in the funnel and then drop the funnel, the button... Then we've got to drop the cube. Maybe I can better gauge it from this side. Okay, there we go. This explains why the funnel is so slow, though, because we need to do lots of maneuvering about in the funnel. So, then what they did was this. They then ran which perfectly does that. Okay, and that's where I got to. So let's assume we need to do everything else in this caged environment we've got here. Where do we go next? Now, the reason I was so particular about the laser cube is that they were quite particular about the orientation. So I can only assume we're going to... So we could potentially sendificate now that we have this method of sort of maneuvering things around. So to do that, we would respawn the reflector, drag it towards us there, push it down using the top one there. Okay. Then we could sendificate it through the laser, through the fizzler. Which is all well and good. But my big issue is then how do we get a cube over here. Alright, let's just see how this plan plays out a minute. So we're gonna wanna do this. Just got it. Okay. So now we'd want to do... the same that we did before. With the weighted cube this time, so that we send, and then we change the sendificator to is that in line? Yeah, that's in line with that. Okay, so we change the portal to there. When it's coming over here, we change it to the laser. As that drops, it will sendificate the laser over there, pointing in that direction, which will open the exit. But then how do we get... how do we get the cube back? Should we just play with this for a moment and see how we go? Okay. Actually, I can do this from here, right? I'd need to catch the cube, though. Oh, that's pointing the wrong way. So from up here, how would we turn the cube? Where are we up to? Laser cube is there. Okay. Can I use the... Because ceiling portals are flipped, right? Problem is there. All right, let's. Let's do this a moment. Okay. I did some separation work. Yeah, it's definitely rotated the cube, which is what I wanted. See, I'm not close enough to... Could I just move the weighted cube out of the way until I get that one in position? Possibly. Alright, so that needs to come out of the... That now needs to be sucked through the ceiling portal. Okay. That's safe for now. Oh, but wait a second, I can't do that. So I can't do that because I put it there. I can't then Damn it. Yes, I can, because I can send, I can put it on the syndicate run. Jeez. All right. Right, that doesn't matter. Pull this through the ceiling. Push it over to here. Okay. Oh. What if I can catch that through there? We're close. Yes. Well, I can't take all the credit in this one, unfortunately, because I didn't solve it all on my own. I had to refer to the walkthrough, because I just, once I got the weighted cube up here, I had various options, but none of them really made sense, and I never contemplated that I'd do like the second half of the map as like a caged animal in here. But very good map, Narkodes. Very good map indeed. Thoroughly enjoyed that one. And I'm glad that the Centrificator was used more than once. I kind of written off a second use for the Centrificator earlier on in the video. But yeah, once I was up here and I'd seen in the video how to respawn that, I think the rest clicked pretty well. The rest did click pretty well. I wasn't too long solving it, but yeah. Fortunately, I can't take sole credit for the solving of this puzzle. Guys, thank you very much for sticking with it and watching. I do appreciate it. If you've got any messages to play, please leave in the comments or head to my Google form. I think that's in the description. But until next time, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.